Each week, we break down a hot topic in the gaming industry. And this week, we're going to talk about something that I can't believe I'm saying this. We need to talk about WoW Classic.
Well, you haven't been able to talk about anything else this week, so.
No. So, World of Warcraft Classic is here. And it is a game in which they have taken WoW back to the days of 2004, vanilla WoW, back when you grinded the shit out of everything.
Technically, it's not 2004.
2005, 2006, one of those.
One of the patches near the launch of Wrath of the Lich King.
Yeah.
So I think it's like 1.3 or something like that.
But it doesn't include those expansions, right?
It does not include those expansions.
But it's just like, you mean like at that state where they fix shit?
Crusade.
Like where they fix stuff and all that?
Yeah, so a lot of it's been fixed. Yeah. And yeah, so it's like a few years after launch.
Gotcha.
Anyway,
so,
go ahead.
Yeah, so we went back to that. So we're going to talk about how this came to be, why people want it, and why this is really huge for gamers. But first, I want to just give a little bit of overview on the stats. Battle of Azeroth on Twitch has over 500,000 viewers.
Mm-hmm.
But Twitch WoW Classic on launch day, if I believe, mm-hmm. not mistaken,
it's all launch day,
had 1.1 million viewers on Twitch, which is like bigger. It's like, I mean, it's bigger than Fortnite. So people were waiting in line to queue up into these servers because that's just WoW Classic. That's how WoW was. You just waited to connect, and people were waiting an hour long line. Like last week, I streamed.
It was an hour. It was hours.
Oh, that's not. Yeah, it was hours.
Sorry, I thought you said hour.
I said hour, and then I kind of said hours, and then I was like, because some people were waiting like an hour at the beginning,
mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
then it got bigger and bigger to where it became hours, and then hours upon hours. I heard somebody say like 9 hours was the waiting time that they had in one server. I streamed with Louise last week on a Borderlands 2. And about 45 minutes into our stream, he was like, hang on a second. And then my game got super laggy because he was hosting the server. I was like, why is it getting so laggy? He's like, oh yeah, I'm pulling up WoW Classic to queue up real quick. And then so he's queuing up in WoW Classic. And then he jumps back in the game. And we proceed to play 2.5 more hours. And then finally, by the time we're done, he's like, oh, I got about 5 minutes left in my queue. I was like, are you shitting me? 2.5 fucking hours to queue up to this game. And then like people, there's so many people, there's all these quests that people have to do. They're waiting in line for quests, which we'll talk about later. But this is insane. It's been nuts. Like that's why Control didn't get any like acknowledgement last week, because WoW Classic fucking came out. And then now we have a Discord channel dedicated to WoW Classic, a text chat. And everybody in Discord is playing WoW Classic. Okay, anyway, Austin,
yes.
Tell me your thoughts about WoW Classic. Yes. Why is this happening?
Before I get into it, to experience my first 30 minutes of logging in at launch, make sure to go over to youtube.com/theinnergamer and catch the video where I go absolutely insane and basically rage quit from WoW Classic because it was absolute chaos, as the title says. So check that out after you listen to this. So I was like, oh, dang, like, what do I got to do? Luckily, I watched a video, and it's like, hey, make sure you load up WoW Classic ahead of launch so you'll be in the server before everyone else jumps in, and you won't get stuck in a queue. Because, 10,000 or more people were waiting in line just to play this game. Anyway, so I did that. I told Travis. He barely got in on time, and I think he was in the queue for like 5 or 10 minutes, and he got right in.
Yep.
He was lucky. So it was 5 o'clock, jump in, and I mean, what did you expect? Millions of people are logging on at the same time on all these servers, and the servers can't keep up with it. There's people stacking on people. I couldn't even leave my spawn point right when I got on the server for about 30 seconds, which was concerning. I could move around. I just couldn't get out of it. Like everyone was spawning on each other. That's how bad it was. So
were you like skipping as you were moving and stuff like that?
I wasn't skipping, but everyone else was skipping.
Wow.
And at first, there was like maybe 100 people in the area. And then as I like walked away from the lag area, which is where everyone was spawning, I was a orc warlock, so I'm in Durotar in the Valley of Trials. Yeah. So I walked away, I turned around to the spawn point, and more people started, just coming into view. Like they were just spawning in all around me. There was a good like 300 people, it seemed like, all in this one area. And then I came to the realization, oh, fuck. I got a quest. So it took about 10 to 20 seconds to actually accept a quest. And then trying to kill all the mobs for the quest was near impossible. And Nick, one of our Discord buddies, he was like, yeah, just join a group and you can, you know, you'll get done faster. So the first mission was to kill boars. So I was like, oh, easy. Yeah. So I obviously, everyone's spawning camping these boars and killing them all before I have a chance. So within about 15 minutes on a quest that should take you about 5 minutes, I got all the boars, so I turned that in. Then I went to my second quest where I had to kill vile familiars, which are like little imp demon things, shoot fireballs at you. And I was like, I cannot complete this quest. There were way too many people here. And I just like, I just got so pissed off because like, I'm wasting my, what? I'm playing this game and I can't do anything? I'm wasting my time. I'm going to be here for 2 hours trying to complete quests in this area where there's literally hundreds of people at.
I have a question. You've played WoW before.
Yes.
You've probably experienced moments where you've wasted your time before. What were you thinking?
Why? I'm having fun, okay, Brett? You don't understand. You're not a WoW man.
So what is... Okay, well, so...
Let me... Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so I got off. Me and Travis both got off. And I decided to get back on later just to see if I could get back on. And I was stuck in a queue of like 10,000. And I did not... I think I got back on around 10:30 or like it let me go into the world, but I wasn't there on my computer, so I was AFK long enough for it to just boot me back out, and I was like, all right, I'm not even going to play tonight. So the next day, in the morning time, I jumped on, and there was less people there, but still a lot of people, and I was able to complete a bunch of quests, and with that, I realized that I should group up with people. Now, this might seem like a no-brainer for people who play WoW, but for me, when I jumped into WoW early on, and even up to this point, I never really grouped up with anybody unless it was for a dungeon or with friends that I actually know. Like, that's just never been a thing that I did. You know, I've never made friends on WoW. I probably made a few over the years, but nothing significant. But
right.
With this new, like, this coming in or coming into this version, it was a necessity. And I know a lot of people were talking about how they miss the social aspect of WoW. And I really didn't understand that. It's like, okay, like, yeah, you can talk to people, like, you're forced to talk to people, okay, whatever.
But how are you, so it's all text chat, right?
Yeah.
How do you, when you group up, like, do you literally, like, is there a component in the game where you can add a group and form a group, and then now you're, like, grouped together,
yeah,
like,
so you
in
can,
the game?
You can scroll over someone's character and then right-click on their icon, say invite.
Okay.
So it creates a group, and then you have group chat. It's a different color from general chat or just people speaking.
Got it.
In the area. So it's like if you wanted to complete these missions, you had to group up with people. So I actually made a friend. Like me and this guy on the second day of WoW, we quested for 3 hours. And I was like, hey, man, you're really cool. Like, we should quest again soon. He's like, yeah, sure. Because I had to get off and get lunch. And I was like, man, that's actually a lot of fun. Like, he was really chill. I think it was a he. You know, I was really chill. We're doing the same things. We just helped each other out. And I was like, man, this is awesome. So after that, I was like, so this is what everyone's talking about. Like, I did not get it.
Yeah.
And that's what it was. So still even now, like some of the bigger. So we've gotten to the point where the herd is kind of fanned out enough where you can kind of quest on your own if you need to. But there is still a certain. I don't want to call them boss, but like single mob that you have to kill for quests that they only spawn. There's only one of them and they spawn in every so often. So you'll go to these guys and there'll be like a bunch of people waiting for them. And so everyone's like, can I get an invite? Can I get an invite? Like, I don't like if I don't I'm not in a group, I'm not getting this kill. So like people will just stack up over this one person that they need to kill. And once they spawn in, like everyone attacks them. So there was one gay guy called Zala Zane, which is in the second area of being an orc.
Yeah.
And I was there for like 15 to 20 minutes, and my group could not kill this guy. Everyone kept getting him before us. So.
Wait. So when you're in a group, does if anybody in your group kills a person, does that count for the whole group?
Yes.
As a number? Okay.
Yes.
So being in a group makes sense because then that distributes... You have larger chances of killing somebody because somebody could be over here killing a board that spawns by them. Okay. Yeah.
So that makes sense. Clarify more for you is like if you attack a mob in the world, it becomes your group's loot. So someone else
gets assigned to you at that point, kind of, or
like because it'll be like it'll have a red icon over under its name, like a red color. That means it's available. And then when you attack it and it stays that, you see its health and it'll go down, right? And so it's like, oh, okay, like now he's dead and he's my loot. But if someone else takes it, it becomes gray. So it's not yours anymore. It's theirs.
Right, like, so if you're killing a boar, somebody else could jump in there that's not in your group and attack that boar and finish it off and then take the loot that you were working towards?
As soon as you attack that,
it's now, let's say, assigned to you, right? Yeah, okay.
Yeah. So that was the issue, and that's been an issue all the way up until now. So obviously, as more and more people spread out into the world, it's going to become less and less of a problem. But that whole like beginning, that whole social aspect was just so interesting, and I've never experienced it before, and it was awesome.
Yeah.
Like, that is something that you can't experience. Well, you can, but it's very unique to this, and it was cool to see that dynamic really be pushed to the forefront.
Because
the only way to do it.
In other MMOs, like, how do they... Because, I mean, I feel like WoW... I don't ever see this kind of experience where, like, you're connected to a server, and if everybody spawned in that home base, all 3,000 of those people are in that one little space, right? It's not instanced in a way where they only allow up to 100 people to appear. So, like, you could be there, but in order to, like, you know, split out the load, there's only, like, a set number. Like, in this case, it's if there's 500 people at that spot in this server, there's 500 people on the screen, right?
So with new technology, they actually introduced layering. So there are more people in that area than you can see. Quite a bit more people in the same server than you would originally, than what would have been originally in the original vanilla WoW.
Oh, wow.
So there's a lot of people in the area.
Wow.
Yeah. Huh. You just can't see them all.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So I want to go through a few of these stats real quick that we have from some articles and stuff. So we talked about how first night, 1.1 million viewers in the first night of Twitch. That was the top games on Twitch were WoW Classic, GTA 5, and Minecraft, which is interesting. They're all like older games that were like taking the top. It's interesting how, because I saw you sent me a video clip of like 2 or 3 years ago where somebody asked a question about Vanilla WoW or something like that.
Well, let me preface with that.
Okay.
So yes, that happened. But before that, people were actually brought back private servers, which you're not allowed to do.
Right. Yeah. I was going to get into that. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. So, well, let's go ahead and talk about it now because I think that makes sense. So there was, because I have a friend of mine that I used to work with that he was big in a WoW for a long time. And then he stopped playing it for a while. Like he said, he spent 79 days is the amount of time that he had invested into the WoW. So he's not playing WoW Classic for that reason because he's got kids now and stuff like that. He's like, I can't dedicate time to that. But he was saying that, they had the private servers that were around and there was a couple of them that were set up, but they were not legal basically. Mm-hmm. But people would play it to go back to the original days of WoW before they added all the quality of life things and all the new features and then making it easier to level and all that stuff. And I was reading that there was this guy that we'll talk about later, Joker TV, is a guy who has like speed ran to level 60 in all of these private server renditions of this game to get to level 60 in WoW. And he's like known for this kind of thing. And he became the first person to hit level 60 in WoW Classic in like 3 days.
Yeah.
Which is insane.
Which is the record. Because it used to be 4.5 days or something like that. It was three days and some change. So, I mean, he freaking killed it.
Yeah. So to your point about the layering and stuff like that, they said that. So this is an event. The world first race to 60 is an event coordinated by Method, the most famous Warcraft guild, apparently. And they live stream Warcraft events, et cetera, et cetera. And so this guy, Joker, played a gnome mage. And then he did old-fashioned grinding to gain experience points. So he spent a lot of time in the Western Plaguelands, which might be familiar to you. I don't know anything about the Plaguelands, but that's where he spent all his time in. And he uses Mage Frost abilities to draw large groups of undead, freezing them in place while he pelted them with ice. And he just grinded the shit out of that for a very, very long period of time. And then whenever he finished it, 347,000 people were watching him on Twitch when he reached he was about to reach it, and he abandoned the undead fields and then went to a nearby settlement and attacked a Scarlet Paladin, who upon dying gave him the few hundred XP he needed. When he won, he went back to Stormwind City, where a mass of players were there and quickly swarmed him to congratulate him in the game on his win. And then he played Celebration by Cool and the Gang on his stream, which I thought was pretty clever. But in this, he used layering to constantly switch to new instances of the area he was farming for experience, helping him skip the long wait between monster respawns, which it sounds smart. Like people don't agree smart. With. But yeah.
Yeah, people don't agree with it. And yeah. I heard some concerns that people were like, yeah, this guy did it, but who's to know that he wasn't switching out people over time? Or, you know, they're kind of saying that, you know, some people kind of have to. Well, I know. I take that back. They're predicting that people who, because this is a giant race to 60, basically.
Right, right.
And I didn't go in that with that mentality. My mentality was I need to get ahead of the pack so I don't get stuck with everybody else.
Right.
Try to grind stuff. But obviously people are trying to get to 60 as quickly as possible. So people were thinking that, are we going to go with, like, the guy who gets 60 first, is he going to stream for the complete time, you know, like stay up for 3 or 4 days just to get this achievement?
Yeah.
Or are we going to go with, there's a guy who's going to get to this level 60, and did he switch out people who know what they're doing so they can take shifts to get to level 60?
Yeah.
So I don't know what this guy did. I didn't keep up with it, but, you know, it's cool.
Sounds like he 60. Did it all, but yeah. Himself. But yeah, I mean, you don't really know. But it, I mean, I don't know if he, it wasn't clear if he streamed everything, the entirety of it.
Right.
But it was 79 hours of, no, it was 79 hours of nonstop grinding, they said.
Oh, wow.
So that's almost continuous grinding, killing, and questing.
Yeah.
He surpassed it. Yeah, so that's pretty wild. But, and I also found it, like, it's crazy to me, like, the WoW community is interesting. Cause, I mean, we've heard the stories of how, you know, people get married in WoW and people have funerals in WoW and all this different stuff. And in this thing, they had, like, there was so many people trying to turn in quests and, like, do these things that they're, like, literally waiting in line, in a single file line, to get their turn to carry out that next quest thing, which I just didn't think was even a thing that would exist in this game. It's so weird. Apparently, according to this, this was patch 1.12, where the original World of Warcraft pre-expansion add-ons was at its strongest, having had a few bugs. So this was before Burning Crusade,
right.
But the last, like, most stable version that they brought out. And I'm sure, like, more stuff added into it. But what's it? So what I'm curious about is how, why? Like, why are people back into this game? Why is it so big? And I definitely think nostalgia is one of the factors.
Yeah.
But I've heard a lot of stories about, as WoW has developed over time, they brought out new expansions and new updates and things like that that have had added more and more regions and more levels and more ways to level up faster to, like, new points, that it kind of lost the essence of what people came to this game for, which is the grind.
So the Battle of Azeroth, you can get to level 60 in, like, 2 days if you want to, like, and you don't even need, you don't have to be with anybody. You can get there like this, right? You don't have to keep, like, there's no chatting or anything. And back in the day, you had to ask people, hey, where's this quest location at, or where do I find this thing at? And I forget what the quest was, but it was in the Barrens, and me and Travis were trying to find this dead body, and we could not find it. We went all over, like, we probably spent a day or two trying to beat this quest while questing with other stuff. And this other guy was like, hey, follow me, I'll show you where it's at. And it's like, holy shit, we actually went to this area but couldn't find this body. And it was just, like, kind of hidden off just a little bit. So it's like one of those things where now, like, you, if, okay, assuming you haven't played this or you forgot, like, talking with people and making those, again, the social aspect of it, of people helping people out, is, I think, what really attracts people to this. Which is weird, because a lot of people that are coming back have probably played WoW and they know exactly where everything's at, you know?
Yeah.
So, is that kind of
stuff? No, that makes sense. So it's all a social thing, really.
Yeah.
And that's, it's weird that nothing's been able to capture that.
So I kind of relate it to my job, right? I'm a firefighter, I'm a paramedic, I go through hard, grueling stuff, but what makes it worthwhile in the end is that I'm doing this stuff with other people and we understand each other.
Yeah.
Right? Like, it's hard. I think that's the best way I can explain it.
Yeah.
Like,
you're, like, there's overcoming.
There's a connection with us dealing with
like you're overcoming objectives together and like achieving things.
Yeah. And they're hard.
Together.
We create stories, you know, we create connections. And I think that's what this brings here.
Yeah.
Is you're doing hard things, but then you get to have stories and make connections out of it.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think everyone's the way that they're going with games as a service is like, okay, what can we give them that keeps them hooked enough? So it's just easy enough, or probably too easy.
Well, yeah, that's the key thing, I believe, is that they've toned down the difficulties of everything to where it's not, yeah, it's like, let's make it as just difficult enough to keep them like to where there is a challenge, but not enough to where they won't continue down a path of progression.
Right.
To eventually spend more money probably, or do more of the consume more of the content. In this case, it was like, but I'm curious to know, like what about, was it the, I mean, you know, earlier when we were talking control, you were asking me like, what's the drive in the story? Like, why am I compelled to play through the story? Does that exist in WoW, or is it more the gameplay that you're attracted to and the grind with your friends? Like, does the story compel you in any regard as much as like what you were looking for with like say control, or is it more that social aspect and that achievement of progression with your friends that is the appeal?
So originally it was the world that appealed to me. Obviously Warcraft had come out as the RTS and that was cool. And there was lore and characters and fantasy. And I loved all of that. So I was like, this just makes sense. And obviously seeing Travis play, I mean, first of its kind. So seeing it for the first time was like, oh my goodness, this is amazing. This whole world I can travel in. So like that kind of really appealed to me. I really didn't keep up with the story too much. So leading up to WoW Classic's release, I looked up lore for like just basic lore for World of Warcraft, like what happened prior to the game. And I think that's kind of really sucked me into like, oh, this is why this character's here, or this is why this is happening or had happened, and this is like tying things together. So like now I'm more into the lore and the story's kind of driving it here and there. But it's not like the biggest thing.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's just something about it's nostalgia, really, I guess. That's the only way. I mean, the grind is a waste of time, I guess.
Yeah. That's the thing that makes it so hard for me to get into it is just knowing that that grind exists, but it's so many people that have fallen in love with that grind.
Right.
Like that is what they want. And like, you know, people talk about like, I play Destiny for the grind and stuff like that, but I don't think it nearly the has same. The charm as like what WoW does to like keep you invested.
The best thing is Dark Souls.
Yeah.
There's a grind there.
Yeah.
There's something that people have to, that can relate to each other when they're like, hey, I beat this or I beat this boss. It's like, yeah, I understand you completely. I understand the pain you went through. Everyone who did that and went through pain.
Well, I can imagine like with raids, especially in WoW. Like, when did they introduce raids? Was it before did they ever have vanilla WoW raids? They did, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, as far as I know, yes.
Yeah. I mean, I think Leroy Jenkins is before any of the expansions came out and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, that stuff, like, I feel was one of those things where, like, you're working so hard and you're trying and trying and trying and you don't finish it, but you try again. And then you're like, yes, we've accomplished greatness. And you're, like, super excited and thrilled and all that stuff. And that's a pretty big deal. Man, it's an interesting
thing. It has blown up.
Thing.
Like no other thing has blown up before.
And it's crazy. I mean, because this is a weird example. I mean, this should hopefully set a precedence for other companies to show that, you know, there's something missing in games today. Like I was talking earlier about control and like this is a true single player experience that like doesn't exist much anymore. And WoW Classic is like, it's the early days of MMOs back when they were, you know, They were more challenging. They were more involved. Like you had to work hard to get what you were like striving for.
Right.
And I'm curious to see if people quit college for this.
People flunked out of college.
Good and bad.
Yeah. I know. Like people quit their jobs. People quit, lost family and friends or whatever. You know, just for this game. And that should go to show you, like, there's something special about.
It's a good show. We need more of that.
Yeah, I know. In a time where we have no time at all.
Yeah.
Let's
yeah.
bring it back. But people love it, man. Like, it's just crazy. But on your statement you're going to make early on, how was it J. Allen Brack, the CEO of Blizzard, I believe? Yeah. he was, some guy came up to him, right, and was like, hey, are we going to have like servers that go back to something like Classic WoW? And he was like, no, we're not going to do that. Like, you think you want that, but you don't, because there's bugs from the past that are still going to be there if we brought them back. So he just kind of laughed it off and was like, all right, next question. But then a few years later, they announced World of Warcraft. I'm sure he was like, God dang it, why are we doing this? I can't believe we're doing this. And then the seats blow up so much, they have to be sitting there scratching their head like, I don't understand.
We don't understand our gamers anymore. Like, we thought they wanted Diablo on mobile, they don't want that. But they want to play a game that came out 10 years ago. I don't get it.
And such success. Like, someone was estimating there's like 2 million people worldwide playing this. I don't know. I don't think the numbers add up, but there's a lot of people playing this game.
Well, and what I didn't realize is, so when I was trying to figure out how to get it set up, I did not realize that this still required an active subscription to WoW. I thought maybe they're just going to release it as like side content that was free.
Right.
But this is like, I mean, super smart, because now they got 1 million people back in. And after a couple months, when that trial's up, they're getting $15 a month from over 1 million people.
Yes.
That is a cash cow.
Yes.
And that's like, I think, way better.
They've been struggling over the past year just to get anything. And they haven't been making content either.
Yeah.
And I've found that like, this is all Activision. They're like, "Hey, we got to cut corners. We got to see. We got to cook the. Not really cooking the books, but they got to make it seem like they're making money.
We got to cut 800 employees and then announce that we made a lot of money that day.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. And it's just like, holy fuck! If you guys just made content that was great, you'd make money.
Yeah.
So I think this goes to show, and I hope this is a huge takeaway for all developers. Be like, okay, how are we going to be successful? It's not just about making money. It's about how are we going to be successful, because then money will follow.
Right. Well, and I mean, we've talked about this in the past, like trying to, like, what's the solution for microtransactions, like getting rid of those and then doing something else instead. And I think, I mean, as much as I still to this day say I refuse to pay a monthly subscription for a single base game, but I feel like this is, especially if they're keeping it updated and fixing it and making changes, I'd much rather them say, pay us $15 a month and we'll make sure you get consistent stuff, rather than nickel and diming you every step of the way.
Exactly.
You know, because I mean, they're always complaining about, well, there's a vocal minority there, or not a vocal minority, there's a minority of people that pay the microtransactions for a free-to-play game, like the Apex Legends guy said. We're trying with free-to-play, but at the same time, we're not getting a lot, like there's very few people that actually pay for it. I'm like, well, I think this is the solution for that.
Pricing's
like
everything.
Yeah. I mean, even like Apex, I feel like if they charge $5 a month, like,
well, and I don't kept agree it with update, that because.
Oh, like doing the monthly?
So with WoW originally, well, I guess still now, you have to pay $60 or whatever they have. Like originally for the base game for vanilla WoW back in the day was $60 or $50, I guess. And then you pay the monthly subscription. So, but you have a gigantic world with X amount of hours. It's going to be over 50, probably going to be over 100 hours.
Right.
Maybe 200-400 hours of gameplay there. Like that is, I mean, if you want to put in time, factor in time, like you're going to get a lot of content out of that just by itself.
Yeah.
You know, it's a full-fledged game with crap ton to do.
I mean, it's story content as opposed to you're going to get more skins and shit.
Yeah, I don't want to pay $5 for a free-to-play game
just
to go in and shoot people.
Yeah.
That just doesn't work that way.
That makes sense. Yeah.
At least in my mind. If you disagree, please let us know.
Right.
So, like, for free-to-play, it's like, okay, I don't mind there being microtransactions. Just don't be so egregious like the Iron Crown event was.
Yeah.
But that's just ridiculous. But everyone's trying to make games a business, but like if you look at Gearbox, they made very successful games with the Borderlands series. They went on a hiatus for X amount of years, and then they eventually brought it out again, and they knew, I don't see any reason why they didn't know it was going to be successful whenever they brought it out.
Yeah.
But they didn't bring it, they weren't cranking this stuff out every 2 years just to get money. They were cranking it out at the time they thought it was ready to go.
Yeah.
You know, they're in the business of making games. And I think we've lost that with some of these AAA titles.
Yeah. And they were smart too, because they opened their own publishing house where they could help finance the development of taking more time with Borderlands 3 by publishing other games for people, you know, which I think was a good move, because then they got to put man hours towards other things with other groups and pull in some money while they focus on getting this thing to be really good.
And, you know, I'm surprised EA, because with what was that one game? Solitude or something.
Sea of Solitude.
Sea of Solitude. I'm surprised they're not doing more, like giving money to indie games.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I don't know how well that did, but, you know, what was the return on it?
Yeah.
They just helped a few hundred out. I don't know how much money that would be, but they might make some return.
Yeah, I need to play that because it's on my Origin Access part of my pass. Oh, nice. So nice. I can play that for at no extra cost.
Yeah.
Which is cool. So I might pick that up. But yeah, I mean, I think this is a good move on their part to do it. I'm just surprised at how much it's taken people over, but I can kind of see where the interest lies, and like it's back to the basics. I mean, that's why I like playing these little indie games, because like playing Shakedown Hawaii was awesome. I mean, I beat that game. I spent 10 hours and I, you know, 10 or 11 hours and I 100%ed it.
Nice.
And that's, but it's because it was very simple and didn't have any fluff or crap or bullshit in it and stuff. And it's nice to see that today. And I'm anxious for Death Stranding for that reason. I think Death Stranding is going to be one of those strong single player focused kinds of games. And yeah, we'll see where else things come. But
yeah, so what I'm hoping for is actually Blizzard looks and like, okay, we should probably make a single player Diablo on PC. Diablo 4, like, yeah. real quick.
Well, yeah, so I was at a party last night with a bunch of gamers and stuff like that, and it's just crazy to me how many times, I mean, how many times people have said PC gaming is dead. And last night I talked to people, I'm like, what do you guys play? And it's like, well, mostly I play PC, but then I also have an Xbox, or I also have a PS4, but mostly I play PC.
Right.
I'm like, yes, like, there's so many people out there that are, I mean, like, it's so big. And it's just like, come on, y'all. Like, look at your audience.
They're trying. You were
made. Blizzard was made on the backs of PC players. Like, cater to that.
Right. I mean, just like Jalen Brack was saying, you think you do, but you don't. Like, he's telling you what you want.
Right.
And I feel like a lot of these game companies are telling us what we want.
Yeah.
We want what we want. Don't tell us what we want. We're telling you what we
want.
I'll
tell you what I want.
Yeah.
I tell you.
We are your customers. Do you want to cater to us or not? If you do, we'll give you money. If you don't, we'll take our money elsewhere. And they just don't seem to get that.
No. Nope.
And that's been a very common in the last year with all the news that's been coming out. You know, like, oh, you know, single player's dead. Everyone wants games as a service, multiplayer, online all the time, blah, 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 blah. It's like, no. We're telling you right now.
So last question I have to kind of wrap this all up. Where do you think, like, my concern with WoW Classic is, where does it end? Because, you know, this is good now. It's bringing it back. It's making stuff happen. But I don't foresee them, you know, repeating the cycle again and being like, now here's WoW Classic Burning Crusade. And here's, you know, like, it's, there's got to be, I mean, there's only so much you can do in WoW Classic before you're out of stuff to do. Is it going to die off at that point? Like, is this just a short term, like, 3-year thing? Or,
yeah, that's the thing. Like, how some people are curious how long people will stay in WoW Classic. Like, there's going to be, because the main thing was they didn't want to, Blizzard didn't want to upload a lot of servers because they don't know how many people are going to fall off and how quick. So to have servers die and have to merge them is like a huge, not a good thing. Like, it's very, very, very bad. But I mean, to keep them there and there's no one playing in them sucks too, because it's like there's no one to play with, right? And so whether or not this sticks around, I don't know. I'm really curious to see how far it sticks around, but it's very possible they're going to open the expansions up to this. They could rewrite everything they've done anew, because I know a lot of people had issues with some of the expansions, like this was good and that was bad. People, apparently Battle of Azeroth is completely crap and they've lost a lot of subscribers because of how bad Battle of Azeroth is. From what I've listened, like, I don't really play it, you know. I didn't get it. I got the,
maybe they'll reimagine new expansions for WoW Classic.
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
They're going to take the best, cuz what's so great about it is they can take all the new technology now and make it a better experience overall, keeping that same feel, which I think they've done very good, minus layering, which I guess for the amount of people that they have, you kind of have to do that. And yeah, it's very possible that they can just rewrite everything.
There we go.
I don't know what they're going to do going forward, but this might be something to do. I mean, dude. Enough people stick around.
Dude.
They might
weird.
Do it.
Crazy.
I know.
All right. Well, that's going to conclude our discussion topic on WoW Classic. All of the above with how it came to be, why you want it. I mean, it's a big deal. I mean, it's definitely... It's the big craze right now. Like, I thought this was the year of auto battlers, and then that was kind of like in and out.
Yeah.
And then now it's like the year of like WoW Classic and shit. And it's crazy.
So, if you guys want to chat with us about WoW Classic and everything we talked about here, head on over to our Discord channel.
Literally, that's all they talk about.
That's all we're talking about right now. So,
if you are on the WoW Classic bandwagon, join our Discord server because you got a shit ton of people you can play with.
Yeah. I'm right in chat.
Like,
about
we've
all
had
this.
Like 10 new people, I feel like, join just for the purpose of WoW Classic.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So it's fresh.
We're starting a guild soon.
Oh, gosh.
Not soon enough.
What did they say they were going to call it?
The
dock
that,
something?
No. Something about sucking dick, and we aren't about sucking dick.
God. Oh, this is going to be awful.
Yeah.
But anyway. That's all happening. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you go to the show notes and click the Discord channel. If you have any questions or want to contribute to next week's segment or give us a topic of conversation, we'd love for you to visit theinnergamer.net and drop us a line. We're going to take a quick break and come back with our new free games for September and also upcoming video game releases, which I hope y'all are caught up with games. I'm not, but I hope you are because it's the shitstorm is here. It's like from now to the end of the year, it's just game after game after game after game. So, or just play WoW Classic. All right, we'll be right back.
Does anyone want to take my spot? I need someone to play some games so I can play WoW Classic.
we'll be right back.